This is a brilliant dirt box. It's the Kismet analog / digital distortion box from Ramble FX in Minnesota in the USA, and it is a completely 100% analog distortion path, but it is digitally controlled. All of these knobs, the volume, the gain, bass, middle, and treble, and also expression, can be digitally controlled and saved as presets. On board, you've got four presets, and they are indicated by the four LEDs down here, which remain dim to indicate which preset you're on when you turn the pedal on. It is a relay true bypass. If you extend its capabilities to MIDI, and you'll see a little tiny MIDI mini jack on the side, and you get the little lead supplied here, you can extend its presets to 100 presets, meaning basically you've got 100 dirt boxes at your disposal that can be triggered by, you know, a sequencer or a foot controller or whatever MIDI controller you have. Additionally, you can also save expression pedal positions, and I've got my little M Audio pedal here today, and that means that I can control things like, you know, gain swells or mid-range swells or whatever I choose to save, and that is included in the 100 presets as well. So there's really nothing it can't do. This is a Partscaster. It's an MJT body and a Musikraft neck. I think it's basically a rebuild or a replica of Robin Ford's 1960 Tele. And I am plugging it into the clean channel of my MI Audio Iron Duke, and you are listening to it through an OwnHammer Guns N' Roses Basketweave 4x12 cabinet IR, impulse response. That's long, isn't it? There's a lot of talking today. I'm sorry, because this is an involved box, but I will do another clip where I just play and shut up. So here's our clean sound. So when we switch it on, you'll see there that the middle LED, which says live setting, that means wherever these knobs are positioned, that's what I'm hearing. So I can use it as a flat out distortion box, or I can use it, you know, as something like a tube screamer and back off the gain, which I kind of like actually, and then tailor the tone with the bass, middle, and treble. So if I might want to, you know, tighten up the bass, up the mids a bit, roll off the treble, or vice versa if I'm using the neck pickup. As opposed to great sound, but, you know, a bit more juicier. Now I can toggle through the presets that I've already put in here, and I'll show you how to write them in a moment. So here's preset one, for instance. Just a little bit of boost. Preset two gets into lead territory. Three's got even more gain. And four gets into kind of twangy territory, which I wrote for the neck pickup. Now let's say I want more gain, and I want to save that to preset four. Less volume, more gain. So I quite like that sound. I'm going to save it to preset four. How do you do that, Brett? Well, I'll show you. This big toggle in the middle, all I've got to do is hold it to the left. Things start blinking, and then I just select which LED I want to save it to. So in this case, four, and then I hold it again, and it is saved. So next time I cycle through my preset, it's done. Now, if I had a MIDI controller hooked up to it, I could save 100 of those. That's a lot of presets and a lot of dirt boxes. So, let me just reiterate. 100% analog distortion tone. It will go from everything from kind of clean boost through to full on. Saturation. Digitally controlled everything, ability to save presets, and there are three different ways you can change the toggles. So at the moment I've got it on cycle, which means that I'm cycling through these toggles, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. I can put it on just toggle, which means it will toggle between the live setting, which is what's dialed up here, and whatever the preset I've got dialed up is. As well, of course, of being able, as well, of course, as being able to turn it on and off. Now, we haven't looked at, I'll just put it back to cycle for a moment, we haven't looked at the expression pedal control, so I'm going to put it on to position 3, which I know I've programmed here, and I'm going to turn it on. And I'm putting my heel back, which is where I saved the gain position for the heel. You can see that it's cycling through. That's telling me that it's in expression control. Pressing the toe down is going to introduce more gain, which is where I programmed the toe position to be. Neck pickup might be sound a bit better. Useful. It's built like a proverbial brick thing. It's a gorgeous colored blue. It's so well laid out. It's the Kismet analog tone digital fun is the motto that they've stuck to it, and I have to agree. It's not a metal pedal, it's not a tube screamer, it's a distortion pedal that's capable of all sorts of things thanks to the 3-band EQ, and it's going to sound different with every guitar. That's why I've used, you know, something in between. Check one out. Have some fun. See you soon.